To introduce to you, Talia Strader from Equator Coffee, San Francisco, California. I think our judges are lined up and ready if you want to start walking down here. All right, we're going to push your cart out the way. All right, let's meet your judges, shall we?
We shall. Hi, nice to see you. Hello, hi. Hello, hi. Okay.
All right, let's let them get settled. You have some time for a couple of deep breaths. Your timer is right here whenever you're ready. Hit go, we'll talk in 10 minutes. Best of luck.
Why don't we talk now?
We can talk now if you'd like. Actually, that's probably a good idea to make sure your mic is still live and working.
Can everybody hear me? Yeah.
Loud and clear.
Okay.
Good luck, Talia.
Thank you. The Seed to Cup story is an important story, and it's worth repeating. It's important for us to reflect on the journey of this coffee and consider each and every hand that came together to produce it. I've got an Ethiopia here for you of heirloom varieties. It's from Biftu Gudina Co-op, which is composed of 150 farmers. It smells like marzipan. Smell this. You want to smell it? Great. Has a buttery mouthfeel and tastes like cranberries. So, each farm starts with a farmer, right? Planting those seeds. We'll call that one hand. And then I'm going to be dosing 19 grams of coffee into that portafilter. 19 grams of coffee is equivalent to 152 beans. So, if 152 different pickers picked these beans, that would be 152 sets of hands. And then, for ease of math, we're just going to say that those farmers all carried their haul to the mill. We're going to say there's one set of hands to unload the cherry into the Panagos Eco Pulper to depulp it. It is then soaked for 8 hours in clean water. It's then sorted for 6 hours. 6 hours of sorting, that's a lot of hours. So we're gonna call that at least four more hands. It then is laid on raised beds to dry for 10 days. So, 10 days, they're going to be going out there and putting shade nets on the raised beds. Protect them. So we're going to say that's at least 10 more hands for 10 days. So at this point, we're at 167 hands and we're still just at the farm. Now, with my hands, I've been making some cranberry juice, melting down some butter and marzipan, and putting them all together. This is gonna go into your signature drink. We're gonna put about 6.5 grams each into the bottom of the cup. And when I come back, you're going to have as signature beverage composed of the coffee's flavor, texture, and aroma. All right, judges, give this a huge swirl to make sure you incorporate all the ingredients in there. Make sure you give it a big whiff as well, get some of that marzipan aroma. And as you sip it, it's going to come together as a creamy, cherry, warm ice cream. Enjoy.
Let's make some noise for Talia's signature beverages.
So we're going to skip a couple of the hands that were involved in moving this coffee from the mill to the roasting facility. We're still going to count that as 5 hands. We're just not going to talk about it much. So once it gets to the roastery, we've got Ted, the head green coffee buyer, along with his QC team, who have chosen this coffee. And then we have Ant, who carefully roasted it. With a low charge temp, 20% development time, 22 degrees between first crack and drop makes this espresso taste like sweet mango, tart cranberry acidity, smells like marzipan, and has a buttery texture. Enjoy. So finally, we're at the coffee bar. For 15 years, the Seed to Cup story has been my motivation. Every time I question how to dial in a coffee, I consider my responsibility to uphold the quality that has been upheld through this entire chain. The weight of all of that work is now in my hands. So, for your milk beverage, it's going to be creamy and taste like chocolate Teddy Grahams. Enjoy.
A round of applause for the milk beverages.
Thank you. So there's actually no way for us to be able to count the amount of hands that came together to produce this coffee. But with this low estimation, we've got 179 already. Exceptional coffee is not about a single certification, variety, processing method. It's about the quality of work of each set of hands that puts in along this entire chain. Time.
A round of applause for Talia Schrader, Equator Coffees and Tea, San Francisco, California. Talia.
Hi.
I have to say, the first thing that I thought when I saw you up here with everything it's gonna sound bizarre, but it's Mad Max very much came to mind. Because all I see is just how eternal and shiny all of your serviceware is.
Didn't Rita do such a good job shining absolutely everything? She did such a good job.
Right? Again, the team that helps us competitors just do what we need to do in the short amount of time that we have to do it.
Yeah.
So, again, you're another very seasoned competitor.
Mm-hmm.
What did you perceive as your biggest challenge coming into this slightly altered format for the qualifying event?
I don't know. You know, I thought it sounded easier.
There was no challenge. You're like, only 10 minutes? I can do that.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
It's a good attitude.
Yeah, I think so. Right? How did it look?
You looked great, right? You moved fluidly, you spoke your words, you know, said your right words, as the goblins would have us say, so.
You're making a lot of references that I don't understand.
I know, that's what I do.
Usually, you and I, we can joke, we get it.
So what was the process for the selection of this particular coffee and the idea that you really couldn't properly convey the story behind it?
Yeah. We went through every coffee, absolutely every coffee, and every one of those coffees, I was like, this has a great story, this has to be my competition coffee. And we would taste an espresso and we'd be like, we can do better. And so we got to the last one, and we were like, this has to be the one. And it tasted awesome, and we were like, okay, that's it. And I've always wanted to talk about people up here, because as much as I love coffee, people are my passion, and I needed to figure out a way to tell the story through the hands of many.
Yeah. Well, I mean, there's definitely usually a story around people. Well, people talk about the producer, the miller, the roaster.
Yeah.
I mean, but you went way above and beyond that. What was your final count? 172?
179 is
179.
The, yeah. But I mean, when you're looking at coffee pictures or you're going to Origin, you're actually seeing the amount of people working. I skipped so many people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, you glossed right over the importers.
I did. I thought it was funny.
I thought it was hilarious. Okay, good. I chuckled like, out loud.
We're not going to forget about them, but we're not going to talk about them either.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, congratulations. You're always a pleasure to watch as a perennial competitor. And best of luck. We'll see your scores soon.
Great.
Right?
Thanks, Lorenzo.
All right. Round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for Talia Schrader, Equator Coffees and Tea. So we've still got...